Hello everyone, I welcome you all in my Science Academy YouTube channel, and in today's session we are going to do the complete solution of GATE 2020 Life Sciences Excel, and in this we are going to do zoology. The subject code is Excel for Life Sciences and T for zoology. So let's start. Question number one is telling which one of the following leukocytes is phagocytic and has clear cytoplasm. So stem cells produce different type of cells which run into the blood from bone marrow, and that can be granulated. So bone marrow can release two different type of cells. One is granulated and another is a non-granulated or agranulated, which means without granules. And what is the granules? Granules are the small vesicles present in the cytoplasm, which contains a lot of different enzyme, which is used for phagocytosis or killing of pathogen. In granulated form, it basophils, eosinophils, and neutrophils. While in agranule, where the granule is absent, here it comes monocyte and lymphocytes. And lymphocyte later on produce T cells and B cells. So here they are asking which one of the following leukocyte is phagocytic and has clear cytoplasm. Clear cytoplasm means agranule. There is an absence of granules in the cytoplasm. So either answer will be monocyte or lymphocyte, in that T cell or B cell. But here it is again one characteristic feature is there, more phagocytic. The phagocytic nature is of monocyte, because once the mature monocytes become mature, it's become phagocytic in nature. So it is having phagocytosis in nature. So answer will be here monocyte. B cell and T cell doesn't have the phagocytic in nature. So this answer will not be there. And these two are granulated. Next question, which one of the following technique can be used for detecting the subcellular localization of serotonin receptor in intact cells? So serotonin present in the intact cells, so serotonin can pass to the cell and it can be present inside the cell. So how we can detect those location of serotonin? So we can use immunoelectron microscopy. Why we use immunoelectron microscopy? So immunoelectron use specific antibodies against serotonin. So whenever we pass the antibodies, it will bind to this serotonin. Once it will bind, it will give a larger picture image through the microscopy. So answer will be first option. So immunofluorescence microscopy is the best way to analyze, because antibody will bind here and it can give the fluorescence. So answer will be first option. SDS page is used for gel electrophoresis, means to separate the protein. It is not used. Fluorescence in situ hybridization is used for finding out DNA abnormalities, and differential centrifugation for separation of different molecule based on its molecular weight. So here answer will be first option. Moving to next question, which one of the following is not a in situ conservation? So there are two different type of conservation. One is in situ and another is ex situ. In situ means conserving the animal or the plant at its original or natural habitat, and ex situ means you are putting that plant or animal in a different place where they can be safeguarded, like zoo, zoological park, or botanical park. So here not in situ means they are asking ex situ. Ex situ biosphere reserve is a in situ. Wildlife sanctuary is again in situ. Zoological garden is not a in situ, it is ex situ. Zoo, where different organism from different places are bring and place in a safer place, which is called zoological garden or zoo. Biodiversity hotspot, it is also in situ hybridization. So we are asking ex situ, answer will be C. Moving to next question, which one of the following is the precursor molecule for corticosteroid? Corticosteroid is a lipid एंड इट इज़ बेसिकली सिंथेसाइज फ्रॉम कोलेस्ट्रॉल. कोलेस्ट्रॉल कन्वर्ट्स आफ्टर सर्टेन रिएक्शन, इट विल कन्वर्ट इनटू प्रोजेस्टेरोन, प्रोजेस्टेरोन एंड देन दिस विल कन्वर्ट इनटू फर्दर प्रेजनिनोलोन and then this pregnenolon is going to be precursor for three different signal molecules that can be mineralocorticoid corticoids or they are testosterone or they are corticosterol. Now this mineralocorticoid is also known as, common name is corticosteroid, and this corticosol is also known as glucocorticoid and testosterol estradiol. बोलिए क्या हुआ. सो हेयर दे आर आस्किंग विच इज ए प्रिकर्सर मॉलिक्यूल ऑफ कॉर्टिकोस्टेरॉइड. दिस इज कॉर्टिकोस्टेरॉइड, सो इट्स प्रिकर्सर मॉलिक्यूल इज प्रेगनिनोलोन. आंसर विल बी सी ऑप्शन. मूविंग टू नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. ट्रांजिशनल एपिथेलियम is found in which of the following organelle? Transitional epithelium is basically derived from equamous epithelium. Equamous epithelium, which is basically used for filtration. It is a very high thin layer and it is very fast. It can exchange all the material. So it is used for exchanging or filtration. So it's present basically in urinary blood. Answer will be D option. Next question. Visual signal transduction cascade is activated by rhodopsin and involved in degradation rather than synthesis of which one of the following secondary messenger molecule? So once rhodopsin is getting activated in presence of light, it activated transducin alpha, just like GPCRG coupled cell receptor protein. It will also activate transducin G alpha after binding with GTP. It's replaced by GDP is replaced by GTP, and then it's become activated, and it's activate, then it activate guanyl cyclase, and this guanyl cyclase will convert GTP into cyclic GMP. So answer will be here, cyclic GMP. Answer will be C option. Moving to next question. The genome of both human and Drosophila code for amylase that act on a same substrate. However, the sequence of nucleotide in gene in code 2 are dissimilar. This is an example of which one of the following evolution. Okay, it is telling human genome and Drosophila genome are totally different. Okay, because they are two different organisms, but they code amylase, which shows similar function. Although the gene responsible for coding this amylase is having different nucleotide sequence, but it is coding the similar kind of or same protein. So this is an example of convergent. Convergent means converging. Different species showing same property is known as convergent evolution, or same species showing different property will be divergent. So here they are showing that different species same type of property, it will answer will be convergent. Moving to next question. Round dance is performed by forager bee to indicate the distance between food source and their colony. Which one of the following is best represent to this distance? Okay, so there are two type of dancing. One is a round dance and another is regular dance. Round dance indicates food located close by almost 45 meter, and regular dance shows food or water location far away. So up to 45 meter and greater than 45 meter. So answer will be here. It will be used for indication the food source which is located 45 meter. Answer will be first option. Which one of the following phyla has coenocytes? So coenocytes is also known as collar cells, and it is having flagella which ensure movement of which cause movement of water to blastocele, means inside the cell, so that once the water is coming inside, it will get the nutrient, oxygen as well as food material, and the exit water will take away the waste material or excretory material or even CO2. So this basically ensure the movement of water inflow to the body. It's present in the porifera. Answer will be D option. Moving to next question. Which one of the following glial cell is not derived from ectoderm? So astrocytes, except microglial cells, all cells are derived from ecto, which is a part of nervous system. Microglial derived from mesodermal. So answer will be B option. Next question. Tarantulas and mosquitoes both belongs to the phylum Arthropoda. Which one of the following represent the correct number of leg in them? So correct number, what is tarantula? Tarantula is a spider. So it is having 8 leg, and phylum and mosquito is having 6 leg. So answer will be 8 and 6. D option is correct. Next question, it is telling match the following subcellular organelle and one with associated with the function of column 2. So these are the organelle and these are the function. Nucleolus is present in the nucleus and it is responsible for synthesis of rRNA, and that leads to ribosome synthesis. So P, it will be fourth one is correct. Peroxisome is organelle where the fatty acid oxidation occurs if mitochondria is non-functional. So it's here oxidation of fatty acid and amino acid occur. Endoplasmic reticulum is basically used in glycosylation of biosynthesis process, and Golgi body used for protein trafficking. So P4, Q2, R1 and S3. Yes, this is correct answer. Moving to next question. Which one of the following genetic disorder in column 2 is associated with the chromosomal changes in the column 2? Okay, these are the disease and these are the factor responsible. Klinefelter syndrome is XYY. Klinefelter syndrome is an increase in the either chromosome, sex chromosome XXY, or so answer will be here 47 XXY. So here this one is correct. Down syndrome is a trisomy of 21. Turner syndrome is 45 NX0, and Kreidl-Chat syndrome is 5P minus. Yes, so P3 and Q4, R first and S2. Yes, answer fourth is D option is correct. Next question, match the following component listed in column 1 with respective organ in column 2. So these are the component and these are the organ. So endolymph is basically present in ear, we know that. It is in class 12th. You can go for NCRT, you can find all these things in animal physiology chapter. Vitreous humor is present in the eye. Vasa deferens present in the testis, and corpus luteum present in the ovary. Then P second, Q fourth, R first, S3. Yes, answer first is correct. Moving to next question, match the following digestive enzyme column 1 and their respective function. So these are the digestive enzymes and these are the functions we have to match. Arabsin is basically used for conversion of polypeptide to amino acid. It break down peptide bond. Strepsin is used for conversion of fat into fatty acid and glycerol. Pepsin is used for conversion of protein to peptide. And enterokinase is used for activation of trypsinogen to trypsin. Yes. So then P4, Q3, R1, S3. Answer will be B option. Next question, which one of the following graph represents the relationship between ventricle and diastolic volume and cardiac output in a healthy adult individual at rest and upon exercise? Okay. So what is a ventricle and diastolic volume? Amount of This is during the relaxation process. Diastole is a relaxation. So once the muscle, heart muscle contract and relax, this is a relaxation. And during the relaxation, amount of blood pump is known as cardiac output. This is around 60 ml per pump. It pumps the blood. So this is the relationship of relaxation and the pumping of blood, which is cardiac output in relaxed condition. When we do exercise, this quantity will increase because our body requires more oxygen, more glucose. So this pumping will increase. So dotted line is showing exercise. So it will be always above, greater than the solid line, which is for normal. This is for normal. And this is for exercise. So answer will be first option, because it's keep on increasing and this one is above that. So answer first option is correct. It won't be there, because this is also above, but this is decreasing. It should be keep on increasing, because we are doing the regular exercise. So volume and as well as diastolic volume should be increased. So it should be in increasing order. Answer first is correct. Moving to next question, match the household insect vector column 1 with associated disease. So these are the vector and these are the disease. So we know that sandfly causes Kalaazar. It causes Kalaazar. And oriental rat flea cause bubonic plague. Then scufflet and Q4. Yes, so P, it is third. Kissing bugs cause Chagas disease, and deer fly cause tularemia. So answer will be P third, Q 4, R second, and S first. Answer will be D. Match the protein in column 1 with the organ in which they are maximally exposed in column 2. So these are the protein and these are present in this type of organ. Keratin basically present in the skin. Surfactant basically required in the lungs, so that the it's cause the removal of dust. Procarboxypeptidase is present in the pancreas and albumin is present in the liver. Yes, so P4, Q3, R second, and S first. Yes, C option is correct. Moving to next question, the graph below shows the activity of enzyme pepsin in presence of inhibitor aliphatic phenol P and N-acetylphenylalanine Q. Which one of the following represent the nature of inhibition by P and Q? Okay, so this is without inhibitor and these are with inhibitor. So we have to compare the graph. So same point. So it's always signature graph of competitive inhibitor. So P is showing competitive inhibitor. This is signature graph of non-competitive. If it would be uncompetitive, the uncompetitive will be graph parallel line. So this is for uncompetitive. So it is not parallel line, it is just like this one, so it will be non-competitive. So this is non-competitive. So answer will be non-competitive and competitive. Answer will be B option. Next question, in Drosophila, the red eye phenotype is dominant over recessive white eye mutant. In the mixed population of red and white, 10,000 individual, 36 flies are white eye, and the percentage of heterozygous they are asking. Here we are going to apply Hardy-Weinberg equation. So Hardy-Weinberg, according to Hardy-Weinberg, P square plus Q square plus 2PQ is equal to 1. So this is homozygous dominant, this is homozygous recessive, and these are the heterozygous. So here it is telling red eye, which is dominant over recessive in mixed population, red and white eye of individual, 36,000 are white fly, means Q square are how much? 36,000 out of how much? 10,000. So Q value will be the square root of 36,000 divided by 1,000. 10,000, it will be 10,000. So here it will be 10,000. So this value will be cancelled. It will be 6 by 10 and 0.6. So another, we know that P plus Q is equal to 1. So P plus 0.6, which is Q, is equal to 1. So P will be 1 minus 0.6, its value will be 0.4. So P square will be 0.4 होल स्क्वायर, सो इट विल बी 0.16. नाउ 0.16 आउट ऑफ हाउ मच, 1. सो इन 1 इट इज 0.16. सो फॉर 10,000 पॉपुलेशन 0.16 मल्टीप्लाइड बाई 10,000, सो इट विल बी 1600. सो 1600 विल बी होमोजाइगस डोमिनेंट. सो रिमेनिंग हाउ मच वी कैन आइदर यूज 10,000 माइनस 1600 माइनस एंड दिस वन रिमेनिंग हाउ मच 3600. आइदर यू कैन डू दिस वे, सो इट्स वैल्यू विल बी 10,000 माइनस हाउ मच 5200 and this value will be 4800 then heterozygous. Or we can do another way, 2PQ, we know the value of 2P value, we know how much, 0.4, and Q value is known, we know 0.6. so 0.4 into 0.6, so it will be 0.48, right? 0.48 in 1, so for 10,000 we will multiply with 10,000, so it will be 4800. So this value or this value are same. Okay, now they are asking percentage. So for percentage, I will change the color. For percentage, what we can do, for percentage, 4800 divided by 10,000 into 100, this will be percentage. So this value, this value, this value, this value cancel. So it will be 48%. Answer will be 48% or 0.48. Okay. With this, I solved all the paper from microbiology subject from GATE 2020 life sciences subject. Hope so that this video is going to be helpful for you. Kindly do share among your friend. Also like this video. And if you have not yet subscribed my YouTube channel, please do subscribe my YouTube channel so that you can get the notification of these kind of videos. And on regular basis, I am keep on uploading GATE previous year solution from life sciences or biotechnology. Thanks a lot for watching. We will meet in next video. Take care. Bye bye. ऑर्गेनेल एक्स वाई वन सो इट्स ड्राइव फ्रॉम ब्लड एक्सेप्ट माइक्रोग्लियल सेल्स. माइक्रोग्लियल सेल्स सो इट्स कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स फीचर प्रेजेंट इन द फाइला पोरीफेरा. एग्जाम्पल विच बट शोइंग डिफरेंट टाइप कन्वर्जिंग मीन्स डिफरेंट स्पीसीज शोइंग सिमिलर प्रॉपर्टी. एग्जाम्पल ऑफ सो दिस इज एग्जाम्पल ऑफ डाइवर्जेंट डाइवर्जेंट एवोल्यूशन डाइवर्जेंट सॉरी इट्स वन एंजाइम ट्रांजिशनल एपिथेलियम दैट कुड बी टेस्टोस्टेरोन दे आर टेस्टोस्टेरोन प्रोजेस्टेरोन and this will convert into progesterone so this cholesterol will convert into gravity or iska first option hi hai na T का सेकेंड ए यस सेकेंड ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन माइक्रोस्कोपी कैन यूज एंड दिस सेरोटोनिन विल हैव बाइंड एंड इट गिव्स कलर सो आइदर वी कैन यूज इम्यूनोफ्लोरोसेंस ऐसे और वी फॉलोइंग सेल आई शैल रिमूव दिस वन होप सो इट इज क्लियर मूविंग टू So this is the categories. Comes, which means friends. So this is Excel Life Sciences and T is a geology subject code. So in today's session, we are going to do the complete solution of this geology question paper. And in today's session, we are going to do the complete solution from GATE 2020 Life Sciences whose code is Excel. And in this GATE 2020 and in this video today,